हेलो एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल. वेलकम टू साइंस क्लास. सो एज वी हैव फिनिश्ड चैप्टर 10, रेस्पिरेशन इन ऑर्गेनिज्म, नाउ इट्स टाइम टू समराइज द चैप्टर. सो लेट्स डिस्कस इट हियर. एवरी ऑर्गेनिज्म नीड्स एनर्जी टू कैरी आउट लाइफ प्रोसेसेस लाइक टू ग्रो, टू डेवलप, टू वर्क. वी इवन रिक्वायर एनर्जी वाइल स्लीपिंग, राइट? So where do we get this energy from? We get this energy from food. The digested food reacts with oxygen and releases the energy. So this process, which involves the inhalation of oxygen to release out energy and exhalation of carbon dioxide, is called respiration. So respiration is where we inhale oxygen. That oxygen is used by our cells to get energy and exhalation of carbon dioxide. Now the next one is respiratory system. Respiratory system we will discuss with the help of this further slide.
The parts of human respiratory systems are nostrils, pharynx, trachea and lungs. Let's discuss them one by one. First one is nostrils. The nostrils are external openings to let the air into the nasal cavity. Air is passed from nostrils through nasal cavity. The hair present in the nostrils and the nasal cavity trap any dust particles present in the inhaled air. A slimy substance called mucus present in the nasal cavity moistens the air and traps the germs. The blood circulating through the nose warms the inhaled air. This cleans moist and warm air, then passes through nasal cavity. Then the next part is pharynx. Pharynx is the region after the nasal cavity that leads into the trachea. So basically this pharynx joins the nasal cavity to trachea. Then the third part is trachea. It is guarded by an opening called glottis, which gets covered by the epiglottis when we eat or drink. It leads into the voice box or larynx, containing vocal cords that vibrate when air passes through them. So in the picture you can see this trachea divides into two tubes, which is called bronchi, which enter into the lungs. Each bronchus further divides into tiny branches, which we call them bronchioles. These bronchioles terminate into tiny air sacs called alveoli. The walls of alveoli are very thin. Diffusion of gases takes place through these walls. Alveoli have a rich supply of blood through a dense network of capillaries present around them. Then the last part is lungs. Lungs are the main respiratory organs. You can see on both the sides these lungs are present. They are located on both sides of the chest cavity. The air travels from nostrils to the lungs through the nasal cavity, pharynx and trachea. It finally reaches the lungs through bronchi. The lungs are pink in color and spongy due to the presence of air spaces and a large number of blood capillaries filled with blood. The lungs are protected in the rib cage and supported by flat muscles at the floor. You can see here is a flat muscles at the floor of this lung, which is called diaphragm.
Now the third one is cellular respiration. As I told you during interactive classes that cellular respiration occurs in cells. Here what happens? The oxygen is consumed by the food, like the glucose. The oxygen helps in breaking down this glucose into carbon dioxide, water and energy is released. That is called cellular respiration. So after this reaction, when glucose breaks down with the help of oxygen, it releases carbon dioxide, water and energy. Then this energy is used by our cells to do our work. Then the next one is types of respiration. There are two types of respiration based on the utilization of oxygen. So the first one is aerobic respiration. Aerobic respiration means when the oxygen is utilized by the cell to to break down the food. Anaerobic respiration, this occurs when oxygen is not there. So in this case, what happens? Oxygen is absent, so the sugar will convert directly into alcohol. That process is called fermentation. So in aerobic respiration, oxygen is involved. In anaerobic respiration, oxygen is absent. Okay, so this was about the chapter. So I hope you have understood the chapter very well. So I will see you all in the next class. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.